Erica Anderson, and I'm the curator of mineralogy here at the Museum of Nature. And we're standing here in the mineral collection room, which is not normally open for open house. And as you can see here, we have cabinets full of our mineral treasures. And here in the collections, we have four sub-collections. We have the National Mineral Collection, we have a rock collection, we have a gem collection, and we have something called an occurrence collection, which is for different mine occurrences. And we have about 50,000 specimens. And we're adding collections in different ways. Like currently we have the National Meteorite and Tektite collection. And this is from the Geological Survey of Canada's project to rehouse some of their collections here. You know, geology knows no borders, so we try to have collections from all over the world to support our research, but also mostly Canadian specimens. So excitingly, we have just acquired a brand new collection called the Jilhino Mont Saint-Hilaire collection. It's about 8,000 specimens from this locality that is super unique, and it's full of rare, beautiful mineral specimens and a ton of specimens for our research. So this is one of my favorite specimens from the Mont Saint-Hilaire collection. This is a mineral called Carltonite, and it's well known for being this kind of bright blue, though this is the best blue I've ever seen for Carltonite, and one of the biggest, most crystallized samples I've seen. Here we have a specimen from the mineral collection, and this is lazulite, and it's from the Arctic, so this is from the Yukon, where there's a kind of famous mineral occurrence called Rapid Creek. And it's also from the Pinch collection, which is a major acquisition we did in the late 1980s, which added 16,000 new specimens to the collection. In this video series, you will meet Glenn Poirier, one of our research assistants, who will talk about the meteorite Allende, which holds grains to the early solar system in it. He will also talk about the scanning electron microscope and how it is used to study rocks, minerals, and meteorites. We will also meet Aaron Lussier, who will be talking about the science behind giant crystals, and Ralph Rowe, as he talks about his powder X-ray diffractometer and how it is used to identify mineral species and also used to describe new mineral species. I hope you enjoy learning about the mineral collection and why we're so passionate about working here.